directions, one of them being how deadly the disease is, how to prevent yourself or protect yourself, where it actually is. There are, unfortunately, a lot of people that are trying to capitalize on the fact that there's an abundance of confusion right now in claiming that they have coronavirus, for example. Like, there was a story in the New York Times about teens claiming currently that they have coronavirus to gain more street cred. So it's honestly pretty hard to pinpoint exactly what the most popular misconceptions are, but they're abundant.
Now, as we heard in that report, the World Health Organization called this new coronavirus a massive infodemic, referring to this overabundance of information from so many sources that it makes it hard to decipher what's true and what's not. What can realistically be done by social media platforms to manage that sort of volume of information?
Honestly, it's a pretty unsolved problem right now. I think the WHO is doing a really good job of partnering with these companies to try and push up the most trustworthy sources of information to the top of Google, Twitter, Facebook. But social media companies are also trying to clamp down on misinformation by taking down false posts, false videos. But the fact of the matter is the number of people who generate false information completely outweighs the number of content moderators and the algorithms that are trying to take this down. So it really is kind of a cat and mouse game that doesn't really have a very good resolution at the moment. So one thing that I would strongly recommend for people that are looking for verified, trustworthy health information is to rely on sources like the World Health Organization and the CDC.
So then what advice would you give for people who are capitalizing on this in a negative way about some of the negative consequences that come from some of these fake news and this infodemic?
I would really hope that they can understand that when you promote disinformation and confuse the public about something as serious as the novel coronavirus, you really put people's lives at risk, because as we as people develop less and less trust about all sources of information, they also stop relying on trusting reliable information, and they become unable to protect themselves.
And just quickly, we've seen some of this backlash go from online to offline, some racist behavior towards Asian communities and their businesses. How should we be handling this sort of backlash?
I mean, part of the backlash is very much fueled by this misinformation, because it's created such an environment of uncertainty and doubt that's led many people to not know how to deal with the fact that primarily the impacted populations are in the APEC region. And frankly, if people focus on getting the best trustworthy information from the World Health Organization, from the CDC, and they follow those guidelines, I think that it can help subdue that uncertainty and kind of clamp down on the current racist, xenophobic rhetoric that is spreading right now.
Thank you for your insights, Karen Howell.